Okay, well, we might as well go to this place first. So I'm guessing this is where our fiancé is.
There he is, my future son-in-law. And how's he doing today? What brings him to the Potsdam household, huh?
Oh, God. I came to see Stephanie.
Oh, you'll have to ask the missus about that. Stephanie's grounded to the wedding. Can't have her changing her mind at the last minute. Not with all that meat at stake.
Great. You guys are crazy, too. Fantastic.
I haven't seen my father. He's locked in a room. I hear him moaning. But that's all.
He's not going to die, is he?
Like I said, I don't know. That woman, Mom, tends to him herself.
Well, next time you see him, be sure to tell him that I said hello. And tell him that I'm praying for his speedy recovery. And also, would you remind him about the meat? Especially about the meat.
Yeah, fine. If I see him.
I should be more concerned. If he dies, then who's going to take over the slaughterhouse? Who's going to tend to the meat? I guess as his son, you'd take over. Right?
You seem to be really crazy about meat. slightly concerned.
I can't imagine a better job than working in a slaughterhouse.
Let's sure, make him happy.
It'd be just dandy. And you can't argue with success. Everyone in Harvest gets their meat from your dad. What a grand business to go into. Oh, sure. Cutting animals open may not be much fun. Reaching into their bodies and yanking out the bloody guts, intestines dangling and slapping against you, the smell of death and shit in your nostrils all the time. Well, those are all definite cons. But what you've done? The guts have been washed into the gutters. What are you left with? Meat. Rows and rows of scrumptious red meat.
You didn't need to get into... you didn't need to get that descriptive. I don't know what that was up with that audio glitch there, but... Yeah. Also, I noticed that he's got a painting or a picture of meat up on his wall, so...
Meat is the foundation of any decent society. Everyone needs at least 3 servings of red meat a day. And anyone who says otherwise is a commie.
Wow.
And once you're married to Stephanie, I'll be part of the family too. And your father will give me all the meat I want. Kind of makes up for not getting into the lodge.
Sure.
I haven't seen my father.
He's not...
Like...
Well, you should... If it isn't my...
Why are you so anxious to get into the lodge?
There's wonders inside. I've heard there's more meat in there than they know what to do. Now that you're of age, Steve, you might go down to the post office and fill out a lodge application. They're always looking for new blood.
Sure.
Tell me about this wedding.
Well, it looks like we're going to have to hold the wedding down at the funeral parlor, since I'm not a member of the lodge. Mr. Moynihan has given his okay, and your father is going to cater the affair with plenty of meat.
Funeral parlor. Interesting choice. Could have had it anywhere else in the town, I'm guessing. Okay.
Moynihan is the undertaker. He also runs the Wayward Hotel. Since he's providing the space for the wedding, You might stop by and say hello to him, just to be sociable. But whatever you do, be sure to say hi to your father for me. Will you do that? Tell him hi, and remind him of the meat.
What is with you and the meat? Ew. Okay, so there's squirt on it. You definitely don't want to sit on that. Nothing really there. What about this version? Man on the house squeezing his meat. I'm just gonna let that be. Yeah, I don't want that inventory. I wanna go into the kitchen.
Hello, Steve. Have you flossed today?
Why do you all look so crazy? You just like my mom except with the hair. Okay, we're just talking about Stephanie.
Stephanie is grounded, Steve.
Why?
I'm sure I don't know. Mr. Potvin has sent her to a room, and in her room she'll stay until Mr. Potvin says otherwise. Probably until the wedding. Mr. Potvin feels there's too much at stake to allow Stephanie to run around loose.
She doesn't want to get married either, huh?
Are you saying you don't want to marry my daughter?
I don't know your daughter, Mrs. Potsdam. Why is she grounded? Afraid she'll run away before the wedding?
No! She's as delighted as we are about the wedding. Every bit as delighted as we are. But she might get hit by a car, or a falling piano, or who knows what. Mr. Potsdam wants us all to be one happy family, and he doesn't want to risk anything happening at the last minute.
Can I
see
don't
see any reason why not.
Okay, awesome.
You mustn't be too hard on Mr. Potsdam, Steve. He's a disappointed man. No matter how many lodge admission forms he fills out, they keep turning him down.
I wonder why.
He has a new application in, though. So keep your fingers crossed. If he joins the lodge, you and Stephanie can have your wedding in the Chapel of Love rather than over at Moynihan's place.
Yeah, I have a feeling that's not going to happen because, yeah, she's a little bit crazy.
What can you tell me about the lodge?
Just that they're exclusive and secretive.
If you're curious,
you ought to pick up a lodge application at the post office and take it over to the sergeant at arms. Isn't that a thought? Forget Mr. Potsdam. If you became a member of the order, we could hold the wedding inside the lodge. My, wouldn't that be lovely?
Tell me about this wedding.
Well, it's set for 3 weeks. We're holding it over at Shady Oaks, Mr. Moynihan's funeral parlor.
Say what?
Now, I know it's not a very romantic place, but there's nowhere else to hold it, thanks to Mr. Puck. Mr. Moynihan runs the Wayward Hotel and the Shady Oaks funeral parlor. It's rumored he has connections with the lodge. But the order keeps that kind of thing secret. So Mr. Potsdam has tried to get him to put in a good word for his lodge application. But so far...
Yeah. It's kind of crazy, so...
Your parents.
Okay, let's go upstairs, see if we can visit Steph. The clock has had its metal plate removed. Okay, why? Air freshener. Splice is slowly releasing noxious smelling chemicals into the hallway. Okay, what's in this room? Bathroom. Okay. At least the flush still works. There's some cabinet. Okay, I can look in here. What have we got? Aspirin. Take the hat. So extra strength. Really grateful getting in and out of tight spots. We can take that. Never know, we might need it later. 1 hour cough medicine, take that. Use disinfectant, not to be used for baking cookies. Ooh, oh, I can't take it. I'm gonna try and put it in her cookies. Be sure to roll up the tube from the bottom. Toothpaste, okay. Tampons? Tampons, best, definitely about these. Okay, I'll take the tampons. Used to be vitamins will pick you up. Should take that. Apparently don't need that. Lost 300 yards of it. Band-aids. Nope, we don't need them apparently. Okay, we just pretty much emptied them out. Make sure the wall is hanging. It's a bit crooked. Oh, I didn't think that was gonna happen. Oh shit. I'm actually kind of concerned of why that's there in the first place though. So I'm wondering who's peeking on us. It's kind of weird and disturbing. So I think it's doing it. Nope, we didn't want to see that cutscene again. No thanks. Okay. Yeah, definitely don't want to get a strike from YouTube from that. Okay, what do we use tissues for the trash? Some of them stick to the sides. Well, after seeing that, yeah. It's been taking this plastic plant joke too far. Plastic plant is apparently dead. Someone's been using this plastic plant as a toilet. Ew. Covered with what appears to be toothpaste, pubic hair, and snot. Ew. Okay, let's leave. We know that Steph's room is next door then. Oh, and this is a closet, but won't budge. Summon the thing. It's, you know, one of those things. Yeah, totally one of those things. It's all books about red meat and it's pointless to living well. When did he brought those books? Okay, let's go for the stuff then. Just nice taste. Okay. There doesn't seem to be much to examine around here. Okay, let's talk to Steph.
What are you doing in my room?
Haven't you heard? We're getting married.
So, you're the one. Steve, isn't it?
You mean, you don't know me?
I mean, I don't know anyone. I don't remember anything. How many times do I have to say it?
Just one, Stephanie, because I can't remember a damn thing either.
Really? Oh God, I thought it was just me.
You're not alone. Can you tell me what's going on here?
Those people downstairs have locked me in my room. They say I'm grounded until the wedding.
Okay, is it a revelation?
They claim to be my parents. I can't dispute it because I can't remember for sure one way or the other, but it doesn't feel right.
There's definitely something going on.
Do you have any idea where you do belong?
Nope. No, but I'm fairly sure I don't belong in Harvest.
Yeah. I can't remember anything. But I feel in my heart that the woman downstairs is not my mother. She's like this thing. Like a parody. A bad joke with mother as the punchline. Does that make any sense?
Yeah.
I'm glad I'm not the only one who sees it that way. I thought I was going crazy.
Join the club. But we can't both be crazy, Stephanie.
Either way, something really weird is going on here. I've got to escape. And so do you. Because in a way, whether you know it or not, I think we're both grounded. It's been hell. They treat me well, but they won't let me leave this room. Not even to go out in the yard. Not until the wedding.
They won't tell you why?
Each one blames the other for grounding me. They make up different excuses, different things I did, none of which I remember. So I sit up here, watch the world outside my window, and listen to the noises in the house. Every morning, a weird boy comes to the house and picks up the paper. He doesn't deliver the paper. He picks up scrap paper that Miss Potsdam sets out on the porch for him. Some mornings she forgets, and the boy gets furious. He gives me the creeps.
Anything else you can tell me?
I hear these weird scraping sounds in the bathroom sometimes. Like something is sliding along the wall. Claws, maybe. And Mr. Potsdam, I don't like the way my dear daddy looks at me. Both of them are always watching me. Especially him.
You don't think they're dangerous, do you?
I think this whole place is dangerous. I think we've got to escape. Before it's too late.
Definitely agree with you there.
Escape?
Harvest is a prison, Steve. Don't forget that. Of course I'm right.
Okay, what about the lodge? What do you know?
Everything in Harvest seems to revolve around this damned lodge. This Order of the Harvest Moon. They're responsible for this insane bake sale that's coming, and for the Harvest Blood Drive, too. When people talk about the lodge, it's always in this hushed, reverent tone. Mom keeps telling me that women can't join, but she keeps pressuring me to get you to join.
She's not the only one who wants me to sign on with the lodge.
That's probably the worst thing you could do.
You think the lodge is some kind of trap?
Probably.
I think all of Harvest is a trap.
That's true. Maybe joining the lodge is the way out.
Look, why not explore the town a little? I can't get out of here, but if I could, that's what I'd do. Maybe you can figure out what's happening here without going anywhere near the lodge.
You're really afraid of the lodge, aren't you?
I look at that building, all lit up at night, and I get scared.
Again, with this cutscene.
I mean, look at the damn thing. Seem like a harmless bunch of masons to you?
Yeah, I can definitely tell that the lodge. There's something wrong with it.
Maybe my amnesia isn't total after all. You're familiar to me. Like we've met before. In another life.
Maybe we really do live here. Maybe we were together, and the same thing happened to both of us. An accident. Something.
Neither of us has bumps on our heads, if that's what you're getting at.
Have you been able to remember anything else? I mean, anything at all?
Well, I have had these recurring dreams. Just fragments, really. Strange, abstract images. Liquid, chrome.
Probably just a dream.
Well, have you thought about how to escape Harvest? The wedding is only 3 weeks away. Not much time to get to know each other, is it?
We've had people say that it's 2 weeks, though. So...
No?
If it comes down to it, we just won't take the vow.
I don't think anything in Harvest is that simple. Too many people are determined that we get hitched.
Why?
Potsdam wants the meat your father promised him. Your parents want to force you to settle down. Mrs. Potsdam wants to have the wedding in the lodge. Me? I just want to escape.
And I don't blame you, so yeah.
Come back and visit me soon, okay?
Okay, so let's leave here for now. For the exit. Okay, so I think we're done here for now. Okay, we'll have a look around, we'll have a look around the rest of the town now. What is this abandoned house? It's kind of creepy. Some car. Perfect nesting ground for what? You'll want to stay away from there then. When it is a perfect nesting ground for wasps. Weeds. Place can show you as a gardener. Okay, that is also the perfect place for wasps. There are so many of them. Okay, sure, we shall go, but... Oh, hey there! So this house isn't quite so abandoned. Actually need to. Should remember to actually save the game. That is creepy as all hell. Okay, I think I saved it. Okay, I think I managed to save it.
It's not often that I get visitors.
Are you the wasp woman?
I am Tetsuo Krull. The ignorant of harvest called me the wasp woman. A pejorative, no doubt. Born of fear and a poverty of imagination.
I don't understand.
The politics of honey, the Judeo-Christian rites of sacrifice, and conventional taboos against unbridled pleasure are all responsible for the prejudice against wasps.
Okay, this lady is crazy too. Great. Everyone in this town seems to be crazy.
The politics of honey are intertwined with the age-old struggle of the aesthetic versus the commercial. Because I choose to raise wasps instead of bees, I'm frowned upon by the community. Why? Well, raising bees is acceptable because they produce honey. But sometimes it's not what is produced. So much as what is profound.
I don't see any particular use for wasps.
Why must everything have a use? Is money always the determining factor? More slender, more aerodynamic than the bee, the wasp is a joy to behold.
There's something wrong with the wasp.
Beautiful and juicy. Isn't that enough to compensate for the little drawbacks?
Okay.
Regard the wasp. Wasps produce nothing for others, but only for themselves. Wasps build nests and more wasps, nothing more. They spread into eaves and attics, not to make honey for supermarkets, but to buzz and rustle on their own paper, perpetuating their own agenda, growing stealthily, surely. The most of insects. Innocent children. What better way to describe the wasp? Carefree, wild, beautiful things. If they wish to share their love with babies, or any of the rest of you ignorant hicks, that is not my concern.
Okay,
Well, as you can see, the little darlings do love to sting. Another source of prejudice for the masses, and another reason to love them. Bees are like animals. They sting only for a reason, for sacrifice. They have no conception of individual sensation, of pleasure. When a bee stings, it rips itself and dies for its audacity. This appeals to those raised worshipping a god that demands sacrifice and atonement. But the wasp is promiscuous. They are not as sympathetic to to the masses. Because they don't die when they sting. They live to sting another day. And they take pleasure from it. Yes, a great deal of pleasure. The wasp is a sensual being, not a laborer. Hedonistic instead of industrial. Some think them quick to anger. In truth, they are easily swayed to ecstasy. They penetrate your flesh, and the muscular contractions in their thorax as they pump venom could be likened to the muscular contractions of ejaculation. Each painful welt, an act of love.
I wouldn't describe it that way. Why are these people so weird?